Hi, I am TJ Gunkel, and I'm here to give you your forecast for late week into the weekend, and I am in the CalU Weather Center. As you can see for our region right now, we are having temperatures in the upper 50s, and in the south and the central part of the country, we have upper 70s and even into the 80s. So I'll pull up the satellite photo for you. As you can see, we have some higher cloud tops in the north and also in the west. And that is due to, in the north, we have convection occurring. And in the west, we have, as the trough moves in, it's bringing this convection to occur and colliding with the warm air being brought down from the south. And as you can see here, we have really high brightness, and that's indicating that we have heavy rain, maybe even some thunderstorms occurring. And I'll pull up the radar for you. And as you can see, there are some high values of reflectivity for the radar, and that is showing that we have heavy rain, even some thunderstorms occurring in the north. And in the west, we also have snow that is happening in the higher elevations. So I'll bring up the advisories and watches for you guys. As you can see for our region, there's not too much occurring, but in the south, you can see that there's still some flood warnings that are happening, and that is due to the heavy rain and storms that occurred during the weekend, and that is still having water ponding on roads and making roads impassable, which is causing a lot of problems in the south still. So now I'm going to take you to our forecast. And so for St. Patrick's Day, you see we have some mild weather occurring in our region, but as the trough begins to move into our region, it's going to bring some showers down from the north. And so we were looking for a wet St. Patrick's Day, but it's festive because it's going to be green on our map. So late week, I was saying that trough's going to move in. So if we have the trough moving into our region, we have a ridge that's building up in the west, and that's going to bring some dry, mild weather to the west while we have some snow and rain into our region. But our main concern down here in the south is the low pressure that's going to start to form in Texas, and that will bring impacts to our region, possibly if it takes the right track. And it all depends on which way the jet stream is oriented. If the jet stream kinks up to the north and it allows the low pressure to move to the north, that is when we could see some snow and rain in the eastern part of our state and even into New England. But if it moves out to sea and the jet stream stays normal as it is now, it will move out to sea and have less impacts for us here in the northeast. And as you can see, it will have a higher impact if the low pressure rides up the coast. And if it moves out to sea, it will have a lower impact for us. But it will also bring down cold air, which I'll show in our 7-day when we could expect that cold air to return to our region. So as we have that cold air moving into our region, it will cause that ridge in the west to move into the central part of the country. And that will cause well above average temperatures for most of the central part of the country. As you can see, all over from Texas, even up into Kansas and Nebraska, 15 to 25 degrees above average for that region. So now into our 7-day forecast here in California. We have, as I said, they're calling for showers on Thursday, St. Patrick's Day, and that is as that trough moves into our region. And then for the weekend, it's looking more into the 40s, and that is due to the low pressure system that will move off of our coast and bring down the cold air with it. I am student meteorologist TJ Gunkel. Thank you.